Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to Orchestra Hall. My name is Megan Balda, and it is such an honor to serve as the executive director with this fabulous organization. I'm thrilled that we can all share this afternoon together. It has been an amazing weekend, a marathon, actually, of concerts. We had two yesterday, one today, and each has just been amazing in its own way, and we're so happy that each and every one of our orchestra students has the opportunity to perform here. Where the pros play, as we like to say. Our students have worked so hard since their first rehearsals in early September, and their talents and beauty will definitely shine through here this afternoon in their performances. One of the newest elements of our program that we've added this fall is our new student leadership team. And that group includes about 30 students representing all 10 of our orchestras. So we have students from Philharmonia and Sinfonia East and all the way up through Symphony. And we're just really excited to be able to bring those students together every 2 weeks and to share ideas, to get feedback, to learn from our students, and for them to really start to shape our work as GTCYS in new and meaningful ways. And obviously, the students are developing some important leadership skills through that process as well. And I'm so grateful that many of them have offered to share some remarks at the concerts yesterday and today. And I'm happy to introduce here to my right, this is Gianna, who is going to share a few remarks on behalf of the students.
Hi, my name is Gianna and I play the violin. I'm part of Camerata Orchestra and I'm also part of the GTCYS student leadership team. On behalf of all GTCYS students, I would love to welcome online and in-person audiences to GTCYS' first orchestra concerts of the year. Over the three concerts this weekend, 870 students in GTCYS' 10 orchestras will be performing. I'm so excited to perform here because it's an opportunity to play music for other people and to play music with so many talented musicians. I'm also excited to hear other orchestras play because I can hear different pieces that I maybe haven't heard and observe the higher orchestras. Please remember to silence or turn off any devices so our performers are not interrupted. This concert will be performed without intermission, so if you need to get up and leave, please go ahead and do so in between orchestras. I would also love to thank everyone who makes GTCYS possible. Parents, guardians, family members, music educators, volunteers and board members, alumni and donors whose support makes it possible for students to perform here, learn from artistic leaders, and provide scholarships. You make GTCYS and help us as musicians go in so many musical and non-musical ways. And of course, I would like to thank all the GTCYS students for their hard work to reach these milestone concerts and playing hard. Thank you again for watching and please enjoy the concert.
Thanks, everybody.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Brian Larson, and I'm very excited to start off this 2023 Fall Festival with GTCYS with the Sinfonia East. We're going to play three pieces for you. The first one is Code X by Paul Barker, which is a very exciting, suspenseful, kind of action-filled piece. Then we're going to contrast that with Fantasy on Aloha Oi, which is based on a melody that was originally written by Princess Lili Uakalani, before she became Queen of Hawaii back in the 1800s. And then we're gonna end with Danger Zone from Top Gun. I wanna thank a couple people who have joined this orchestra as volunteers. Max, the bass player, is a member of GTCYS Concert Orchestra, and when he found out we didn't have a bass player in his siblings' orchestra, he volunteered and has been coming to the last 5 or 6 rehearsals. In the percussion section, when we didn't have any percussionists, TJ and Emerson have volunteered to spend a couple of rehearsals with us from GTCYS Symphony Orchestra. And then we have 2 cellists who play other things. And so we have an oboe who also plays cello with us, who's going to play oboe in the first piece. And then another one who's going to play in the percussion section as well. Both Charlie and Emma, thank you. And then our trombonist, for unknown circumstances at this point, didn't show up. And so as of 20 minutes ago, 2 symphony trombonists are filling in, and I don't even know their names. So thank you very much for joining us. We appreciate your support. Thank you, and we're going to get the festival started now with Code X.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. So drama is a theme that seems to unite these seemingly disparate pieces that I chose for this first concert cycle. The opening D minor chord that we just played in that overture tells the audience that the protagonist in the opera they're about to see is going to meet quite a dramatic end. Equally, the transition from that to the super lively and upbeat Allegro is dramatic in its own way. Our next piece by Finnish composer Ilari Hilkila is very dramatic in its harmonic progressions. It reminds me a lot of the music of Sibelius, which I think we're all big fans of Sibelius here in Minnesota. And this composer is also really well known for his video game music, which is kind of interesting. And then the last piece comes to us from the universe of Star Wars. I may be a fan of Star Wars. And I just want to thank the guest musicians that will have joined us to help fill out the instrumentation for this truly epic piece. We have players from Symphony, Philharmonic, and even our own operations manager is going to join us. So we hope that you enjoy it. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Diane Hallberg, and it is my true pleasure to be the conductor of the Camerata Orchestra. These young people behind me are a community of people who love to work hard, they love to have fun, they are curious and musical, and they make every encounter that we have truly joyful, even when we're doing hard work. So thank you, students, for a fantastic start to our concert year. Our program order is slightly different than it is imprinted in the program. So we will start with a shortened movement of the Haydn's Symphony 104, the London Symphony. And then I'm really excited about the second piece on the program, Monarch Migration by Nubia Jaime Don Juan. This is a piece that's part of an initiative called the Mexican Repertoire Initiative. And its purpose is to get music of Mexican composers on international stages. And so one of our local teachers, Matt Oyen, who is the orchestra director at St. Paul Central High School, organized a consortium so that we could commission a piece from Nubia Jaime Don Juan, who's she's a fantastic up-and-coming composer. And Mr. Oyen got 40 other groups, including GTCYS, to support the financial construction of this piece. And the result is something that I think you're really, really going to enjoy. The piece is based on a children's book that is written by local St. Paul author Anne Hobby. The book is called Monarch Butterflies, and it, as well as the music, tells the story of the butterfly migration that moves from North America in the summer to winter over in Mexico, and then returns to North America several butterfly generations later. And I think you'll hear how our composer really beautifully captures that journey in her music. I believe that Mr. Oyen, who is responsible for the construction and the support of this piece, is here. So Matt, if you're here, will you stand? And we would love to recognize you and thank you for your work on this project. In the back there. Thank you so much for being here. And then finally, we'll end with a piece that has a sweeping cinematic feel called Cadence Everlasting by Rossano Galante. So thank you so much for being here for our concert and for the many ways that you support GTCYS throughout our program year.
Good afternoon, Gitsy's friends and family. My name is Andrew Amwa. I am currently a senior at Woodbury High School, and this is my second year playing flute with Gitsy's Symphony Orchestra. Although I've only been with Gitsy's for 2 years, I've already gained valuable life skills that have helped me grow as a person, a learner, and a musician. This wonderful program highlights the importance of responsibility in young musicians, a vital skill for any individual, no matter what environment they find themselves in. This is made clear through Gitsy's motto, play your part. Whether playing during rehearsal or practicing at home, we learned that our responsibility not only ensures the success of our individual playing, but also the orchestra as a whole. As I continue to learn to be responsible through my music, I have become more patient in the time and process needed to learn difficult passages. I have become more observant of the details put into the music by composers. I have learned to interpret the goals of composers and what I need to work on to reach those goals. I have learned to be confident in myself, my abilities, and the parts I play. I've learned to listen for every other section to underpart my role in a piece and just as equally the role of every other section. Just by being involved in music, the skill sets I and other students gain continue to increase. I may talk about these skills through a musical setting, but they extend to all aspects of our lives. These skills work side by side to shape the talented people seated before you today. There is no doubt that the skills I have learned will benefit my life in one way or another, and I'm thankful to GTCYS for allowing me to learn them. Likewise, I am grateful to GTCYS for connecting me with a group of smart, talented friends around my age that push and inspire me to be the best I can. I am also grateful to GTCYS for allowing us to create a space where we can feel ourselves. As we move through our ever-changing lives, music remains one of the few constants we have. It is a way for us to express ourselves, and it separates us from the crazy world we sometimes find ourselves in. During rehearsals, I find comfort in the fact that I don't need to worry about an upcoming test or my busy schedule the following day. Instead, I feel at ease and focus solely on rehearsing. It brings me joy to be able to immerse myself in a moment without any distractions. My fellow GTCYS students and I appreciate all the support we have and continue to receive from those in our community. This includes support from our music directors and educators who teach us and provide us with the necessary repertoire to advance our playing, the members of our community who watch and support and donate to the GTCYS organization, the staff of GTCYS who work tirelessly behind the scenes to make performances like today possible, and of course, our friends and family who spend time volunteering, driving us to and from rehearsals and performances, and buying us the necessary equipment for our new instruments. Many factors can deter students from continuing their music learning, whether it be lack of support, confidence, equipment, time, transportation, or more. Without any of you being involved in our musical lives, none of us would be here on the stage right now. We may not say it often, but I can assure you that every GTCYS musician appreciates the hard work you have put into making our musical lives possible. Lastly, I would like to thank everyone in this auditorium or watching the live stream who took time out of their day to come and cheer us on. We appreciate and applaud all GTCYS staff, parents, concertgoers, and sponsors who understand the importance of music programs and continue to make the journey of me and my peers possible. Please continue to support GTCYS so future students will have the lifelong experience of benefiting from this great program. Thank you so much for your consideration and for being here to support our Fall Festival. Please enjoy our final performance.
Thanks a lot, Adam, for stealing about my lines. I'm telling you. Yeah. He says it better than I absolutely can. Good afternoon. My name is Mark Russell Smith. I'm the artistic director of the Greater Twin Cities Youth Symphonies and have the privilege of conducting Symphony, the group that you see in front of you. Student voices are really important in the GTCYS story, and I'm grateful for Andrew for sharing. Each and every student, each and every of 900 students, many of which you see this afternoon, has a unique story. I think Andrew first came to know GTCYS through summer camp. He just appeared at summer camp and then got in symphony from there and has been in symphony for the past 2 years. And each of our students has that unique story. And as Andrew said, the ability to play here in a hall like this, to strive for excellence, to work as a team, to connect with others who share so much, to develop leadership skills that they'll use later on. Obviously, all these things are very, very important. It's not just about music here, but it's about life skills. That's why we firmly, firmly believe that this GTCYS experience should be open to everyone. We have record enrollment this year, and coming along with that is the record need for scholarship. We want to make sure that every student who wants to participate and is qualified to participate will be able to participate no matter what the financial situation. We give over $200,000 in need-based scholarships. And of course, we can't do that without your help in providing those scholarships. A $35 contribution means one private lesson for a scholarship student. A $1,000 gift means a full year of GTCYS tuition scholarship. But all gifts matter. And so I would invite you to consider, if you're intrigued and inspired by what you've seen already and what hopefully you'll see in a few minutes, then I would encourage you to support what we firmly believe is a hugely valuable thing for these students and for upcoming students. You can donate online at GTCYS.org. You can drop off a check or a cash gift at the GTCYS table. You can mail a gift to the office. And even stock gifts are fine. We would accept those too. But the point is, it is such an important thing in our organization to grant access to each and every person who wants to come and participate in GTCYS. And tuition and ticket revenue only pays for about 50% of that. So we rely on the generosity of people who believe in our mission. And so I would be very, very grateful if you would consider donating to GTCYS. And I'm, again, very grateful for you being here and supporting these young musicians. After we tune, we're going to play two pieces for you. And this is the group that has the great honor of touring. And every 2 years, we take an international tour. And this year, we are performing in Lyon and in the south of France, and then a final concert in Barcelona. And so I've chosen a variety of repertoire for that concert. And you're going to hear a couple of those pieces. We're going to open with the Brahms Tragic Overture. I think it's important that students play all sorts of styles of music, American, German, Russian, contemporary music, old music, just all types. Each and every composer has their own style. And so that's one of the things that we learn here. And so Brahms has a unique style, and a unique sound, a unique outlook, and it's something that we can really dig into and really pour expression into. This Tragic Overture is exactly what it says. I mean, very intense, but also moments of just incredible beauty. So we open with the Brahms Tragic Overture, and then we close with selections from the Firebird Suite. In 1910, Stravinsky really turned the world around by his Firebird Suite, the way he used the orchestra, the characterization through all the colors of the orchestra. It was a really incredible moment, and composers ever since have been really inspired by the three ballets, The Rite of Spring, Petrushka, and this Firebird Suite. So we're going to play for you The Infernal Dance of King Kaschai, who is, as you will hear immediately, not a good guy. Very intense, very rhythmic. And then we have the Berceuse and the finale, the Firebird is asleep. The Berceuse, a beautiful lullaby with a famous bassoon solo. And then you'll hear the Firebird waking up and spreading his wings, and just a glorious, glorious finale. So we have the music of Brahms and the music of Igor Stravinsky for you. Thank you again for being here. And after we tune, I hope you enjoy Brahms and Stravinsky. Thank you.